Today they will be presenting first a first part, which will be a medley of monologues, choral reading, and pantomimes. You may have noticed that I put a rather amusing typo on my program. Possibly you might have spotted it. Any student find her typo? No? Well, I said that there is a choral performance, but I spelled it like the underwater. It has nothing to do with choral, I'm sorry to say, but it is choral in the sense of spoken together. I will now be presenting to you our first half of the program. Thank you.
Thank you. mightiest in the mightiest. It becomes the throne monarch better than his crown. His scepter shows the force of temporal power, the attribute to awe and majesty, wherein doth sit the dread and fear of king. But mercy is above this scepter's sway. It is enthroned in the heart of the king. It is an attribute of God himself. And earthly power doth then show like its God when mercy confuses justice. Therefore, Jew, though justice be thy king, consider this, that in the course of justice, none of us should see salvation. We do pray for mercy, and that same prayer doth teach us all to render the deeds of mercy. I have spoke thus much, to mitigate the justice of thy deeds, which, if thou dost follow this strict court of evidence, must mean this sentence against the merchant there.
Thank you. evil that men do lives after them. The good is often part of their bones. So let it be with Caesar. The noble Brutus had told you Caesar was ambitious. If it were so, it was a grievous fault, and grievously had Caesar answered it. Here, under leave of Brutus and the rest, well, Brutus is an honorable man. So are they all honorable men. Come I, to speak in Caesar's name. He was my friend, faithful and just to me. But Brutus says he was ambitious, and Brutus is an honorable man. That brought many captives home to Rome, whose ransoms to the general coffers filled. Did this in Caesar seem ambitious? When that the poor have cried, Caesar hath wept. Ambition should be made of stern stuff. Yet Brutus says he was ambitious. Brutus is not a man. You all did see that on the Lupercal, I thrice presented him with a king crown, which he did thrice refuse. Was this ambition? Yet Brutus says he was ambitious. In short, he is not a man. I speak not to disprove what Brutus spoke, but here I am to speak what I do know. You all did love him once, not without cause. What cause pulled you then to mourn for him? The judgment, for it fled to brutish beasts, and men have lost their reason. There within my heart in the coffin of Caesar, and I must pause.
Friend, what joy it brings me to see you again. It has been so long.
Distracted, stuck in the world in his head. I want him to look up and see me, not just through me, because I'm in this world. I want him to show me that he loves me more than his music, that I come first. Hopefully one day he will.
House in the meadow after we're married, and all our kids running around, and I'll play you a song every night. Just stay awake. Wait, you cannot take her.
Such concessions are not mine to make. And who are you, a mortal, to take from destiny is taken as his own? No, you are nothing. Once her heart stops, it is no longer yours.
Please. You can't take her. Cruel, unfeeling deities. My happiness was too much for your jealousy, so you took her away from me? Well, I will not let you. I won't be pushed aside as a pawn in your games. I will bring you back, Eurydice. I promise.
Sad. Almost. But not quite.
How did it happen?
Jealous murder.
Suicide? No, we have a place for those types.
No, it was a snake idea.
Well, that's rather...
boring.
I wonder how those mortals...
same as usual, I assume.
Crying. Moaning. Do you hear something?
Really?
It's a mortal boy!
Thank you.
gone. Forever this time.
But if you don't,
you'll never know.
If this is just one more Katie's trick,
or if she needed you.
Okay, have it your way. Don't let
her. I wouldn't let it bother you either.
The disappointment when you turn around and
she's not there.
She is there. I know she is. I trust her.
If you trust her, why are you mad?
When she was old with another, at your wedding.
Doesn't sound like trust to me.
If you trust her,
why do you wish to look back so badly?
She's done nothing to the Lord.
Why are you so convinced she's behind you?
Silly Orpheus. So young, dear love.
It's making you dumb.
Eurydice, I trust you. I do. I just need to hear you. Anything. Just a breath. Or a cough to reassure me is all.
Oh, did you hear that, Orpheus?
Sweet sound of
silence.
What if you're right? What if she's not there?
Finally,
a spectacle.
A girl will go back with a musician.
One who loves another.
Strings. Music. More than the girl he married.
Who daydreams more often about music than the girl he supposedly loves.
What if it's all a trick?
You don't see it.
You've chosen your hobby
over your wife.
Any sane woman can see.
She doesn't want to follow you around like a stray husband. Oh, delightful. If you'd given her half the attention to the instrument, maybe she'd be following you back right now.
But
no. No. Amy said she would be there. She promised. Hello? Anyone there? Eurydice, please, love, answer me. Show me a sign. I can't lose you again. I need to know. I can't take it anymore.
Eurydice! Trust her, you do.
No!
Yeah, right. You trust only what you see.
Now, because of you,
your sweet,
loving wife
will be left to shiver in the darkness of the underworld.
The screams of those in agony will be her only comfort.
And you long for her, and she longs for the rest of your days.
Have ended my suffering.
Well, I have nothing to say. At least you're dead this time. How
horrid.